So Sika are probably number 5 or 6 on most people's exotic list. Quickly found out they deserve a lot of respect. They're pretty tough. I saw one Sika in 3 days of hunting back in October, and now I'm back in the dead of winter. There's ice on the pop-up, it's 23 degrees in the hill country, and the critters are hungry. They come pouring into the corn. Almost everything except a Sika. I had 15 whitetail, 7 axis, and 21 turkeys, and I only heard one Sika buck whistling out of the brush, and he just wouldn't come in, but I still had a fantastic morning. Check out these axes. You know it's cold, and the axes are hungry if they're pouring into this corn. There's a full moon shining. My man Cash Joy was in a different spot this morning, and that's where we ended up this afternoon. We were trying to make the wind work. It was a little bit close, but it turns out Sika are pretty skittish. They definitely know the drill. I've got a whole newfound respect for this wily exotic. Wishing they had a date. All the things. Whoa, whoa. This Sika must have spotted my calling card. He saw the trophy tools clamp and a GoPro in that tree and figured somebody was fixing to get shot. I was so thankful for the whitetail on this hunt. Those whitetail were hungry and they would come back to the corn after the Sika would bark and scare them off. They would act as a great decoy because then everybody else would get nice and comfortable and sneak on back to start hitting that golden highway. Now today there's a back road. I'd really never thought much about Sika. I haven't talked to a whole lot of people that killed them. I just know Ted Nugent sticks a lot at the YO, and we're hunting right next to the YO near Mountain Home with Cash Joy. This place has a lot of critters for a free range, low fence, Texas hill country. Always friends to blame. I'm quickly getting an education on just how spooky Sika can be. That was the third time they trotted off from the feeder. Luckily, they were super hungry, and the whitetail decoys kept luring them back in. But their minds still go drifting down a yesterday road. It was Bones Farm wine, and it was wild turkey straight. Sorry, I just couldn't resist bringing the sign language back. Yep, that's a Japanese Sika coming into the corn, and it's time to stick an arrow in him.
Blew out. That's the last time he blows out. That was awesome.
It's 4 days. I think Sika finally got a shot at him. And he is a monster.
Cash Joy's Hill Country Hunting Adventures is rocking. Will a boyfriend be sure nice to me? So calm down, would you like a drink? And then I shot him for the horse from his nose to his knees. And I polished up on his master guide, Cash. What's up, buddy? What you doing? I think he's a monster in my book. I'm not much of a psycho, actually, but he's pretty tall. I think he's got some. He had a little bit of that lighter hair, like a crossbow with a basketball maybe. And he was definitely the tallest and heaviest one of the four. The darkest bodied one, but probably the weakest in horn, you know, the broken horn, you couldn't tell. And then there's another, he looked a little younger, just because his body wasn't as big. He was tall, but just not that heavy. But these skittish sons of bitches. Holy crap. Yeah, they blew out of here 3 times. Barking and hollering, they come out and mess down this field. And then they'd wait on a whitetail or something to come back. And one of them would get paid and they'd come again. Same shit, you can go back. And finally, they just calmed down enough.
Blurring sun at midday makes it hard to see the road. A lot of miles since last night and a whole lot more to go. The brightness has me blinking and the whole thing's got me thinking on the price of a life of traveling life.
I guess we'll see what happens on the exit.
Trying to live up to the words.
I think he's pretty nice.
Very nice sack of books.
Spend your youth before you die and don't outlive yourself. Lord, that gets expensive on troubadours and minstrels. It's a price of a life of traveling life. What's the price of a life, I guess? Price of a life, I guess. Price of a life of traveling life. Well, I'd like to lay my head down.